Except, who wore their Depends? You're all in trouble, because this is so funny, you're going to pee your pants. So I just warned you, you all know where the bathroom is now, right? Okay, excellent. Okay, so enjoy the show.
Let's try it again. I am Cyrano de Bergerac.
Yay!
I don't even know why we bother rehearsing. Louder!
Yay!
All right, that's better. Let's try it again, right? Let's run it.
You fool, we shall all die. We are outnumbered 10-1.
Be damned your numbers and damn you. I am Cyrano de Bergerac.
Robin Jay!
Halt, who goes there?
Tis the coach.
What?
In the cab?
Tis Roxanne. She brings supplies. Bread.
And wine.
And chicken.
Cyrano, there is a Comte de Guiche you inserted. Stop trying to be the three musketeers in one.
What would you have me do, huh? Seek out the patronage of some great man and like a creeping vine? Crawl up against a tall tree where I cannot stand alone? Never. No, thank you.
Oh my God! I've seen mortality at a dog show!
Dedicate as others do,
poems to pawnbrokers.
Be a buffoon and see the smile on
it. Eat a toad for breakfast every morning! Where is my belly groveling in the dust? No, I think. And again, I thank you, no. But to sing, to laugh, to dream, to walk in my own way and be alone.
Grandma.
Free, with an eye to see things as they really are.
Grandma.
To travel any road under the sun or doubt if fame or fortune.
Grandma.
Oh, Rosalind, what a surprise, dearest girl. Oh, you're growing more beautiful every day. You look adorable.
Oh, so do you.
What?
So do you. You look great.
I'm afraid you'll have to speak up, dear.
Grandma, can I get you your hearing aid?
Oh, no, thank you. I don't care for lemonade. Oh, I miss you terribly. It is not the same here without you.
Oh, I miss you too. Hey, how's tour going? Do you like Buffalo?
No, I don't. It stinks. If it was the name for an animal, it would have nothing going for it. I don't mind so much for myself, really. But it's such a come-down for your mother. She played Broadway, you know, in the 40s. And then your father dragged her down to his level.
Oh, God.
If I was a tired old, please, and be movies. Oh, you should have seen him doing Cyrano at dress rehearsal. The man is a walking ham. They should stick cloves in him and serve him with pineapple.
Grandma, listen. I have a surprise. I'm getting married.
Oh, that's wonderful. I always said you and Paul were meant
for each other. Oh, it isn't Paul.
That boy has.
No, it's not Paul. Paul and I broke up.
It isn't Paul.
No.
Well, that's a mistake. You look ravishing on stage together. You could play all the great couples.
Grandma, I'm not an actress anymore. I'm in advertising.
Yes, I know, and it's revolting.
Don't you remember the talk we had at Christmas?
No.
Grandma, this is your life, and mother's and dad's, and that's fine. I'm very proud of you, but I grew up with it. I want something different, something that doesn't drive me crazy all the time. Does that make any sense?
Rosalind, dearest, can I tell you something?
Sure.
I haven't heard a single word you said.
Grandma, can I please get your hearing aid?
Oh, right one glass. Listen to me, young lady. The theater may be dying. The glamorous invalid may be crawling through the desert with but a single lung in her feeble chest, but she's still breathing, and it's all we've got. It's our lifeline to humanity. Without it, we'd all be Republicans. Very tired now, dear, and I'm going to go lie down. Oh, it's so wonderful having you back.
Grandma, I love you. Come in. Come in. Would you come in, please? The door is open.
Sweetheart.
Hey, honey, come on in.
Are your parents here?
I don't think so.
Oh, good.
Howard.
Well, I'm sorry. You know how I feel about this, meeting the in-laws. It makes me nervous.
Oh, you have nothing to worry about.
I'd be all right if they weren't such big stars. The glamorous life.
Howard, does this look glamorous to you?
Well, yeah, it does.
This is Buffalo, New York. It's like Scranton without the charm.
I was born here, actually.
Oh.
I like Scranton, too.
The point is, it's not Broadway. And they're doing rep.
Right. What's rep again?
More than one play. In repertory. They alternate. Right now, it's Private Lives by Noel Coward and Cyrano de Bergerac. Only they've cut down Cyrano for a small company. They do it with 5 actors.
The sort of one nostril version.
It's sort of sweet. You're nervous about meeting them.
Nervous? Look at me. I'm a wreck. Do they know that I'm in show business too?
Howard, you're not exactly in show business. I mean, they wouldn't think of it as show business.
Oh, I am on television.
You're a weatherman.
Right. I mean, it's kind of acting, like your parents.
They do Shakespeare and Chekhov. You do precipitation.
Yeah, I know.
It's a wonderful job. We could settle down and have kids.
I love children. I want to have 6 at least.
Let's start with 1. Now listen to me. I want you to be very, very nice to them. Tell them how much you admire their work.
Well, I do. I mean, my God, when I was a kid, they were on the cover of Life magazine. Shakespeare on Broadway.
Look out, Barrymores. Here come the Hays. They had it reproduced out of China.
Wow.
Then they had 2 big flops in a row and moved out to Hollywood.
I know. I saw every movie they ever made. Sergeant Yukon, Apache Woman. Oh my God, I forgot the bag!
What? What bag?
I have a surprise for your father. When I was in New York last week, I read in the paper about an auction. They were selling off props and stuff from one of the big studios, and, well, I bought one of your father's old costumes. I thought he'd like it.
That is so sweet. Which one did you get?
General George S. Patton. Wait till you see it! The problem is, I don't have anything for your mother yet. I guess she wouldn't take cash.
Word. They will love you for who you are.
What if I freeze up? I do that sometimes when I'm nervous. I can't even remember my own name.
You'll be fine. I promise. All right. I'll go see if they're in their dressing rooms.
I'll go with you.
Well, you stay here in case they show up.
I'd rather go.
Howard, stay.
Nothing's going to happen in 2 minutes.
Oh my gosh!
Hiya!
Hiya!
Alright, the villain!
Stand back, thou knave, and cut purse!
Stand thy ground, or thou shalt bleed from ear to ear like a vomiting spring at flood tide. Witch!
Bone fizzle!
Villain!
What have we here?
I know not, but 'tis passing strange.
Hi.
Yeah. Stand back, or the lad shall die. If thou dost move one inch, the lad shall spurt blood like a fountain.
Don't move.
Ha!
Hold thy head up, vile Scot!
I'll make a ghost of him that lets me, and away!
I have to go now.
Where are you going?
I need a few minutes. I'll be back.
What's wrong?
I have to think about this. You don't just rush into a relationship. It takes some thinking.
Are you crazy? Get back here.
It
what I like most about the author of Cyrano? Mm. Dead. You can't argue with it. Listen, I have an idea about tomorrow's performance. Mm. When the wagon arrives in the camp, I want you to step out, pause, curtsy to the soldiers, and then I'm going to put a spotlight on your face to suggest that you have descended like an angel from heaven.
George, can we try it now?
Yeah.
Nay.
Halt! Who goes there?
It's a carriage.
What, in the camp?
Look, 'tis Roxanne. Oh,
thank God.
Yay. And then I descend from the carriage as if I were an angel from heaven above.
Spotlight.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Roxanne, on the king's service?
On the service of my own king, love.
That's it. Who made the scene?
Cyrano, my best friend, I need your help.
I am at your disposal, madam, now and forever.
George, when you do that, center stage in front of 1,000 people all holding their breath, I can't help it. I wet myself.
Thank you, darling.
Oh, kiss me now before the moment passes.
Don't mind me. I'm just fine.
Well, if it isn't the Hound of the Baskerville. Oh,
don't start.
That's all right. Ethel hasn't heard anything in 20 years. Have you, Quasimodo?
George?
Tell me, Ethel. You frightened any little children lately? Offered them a ride on your broomstick?
George, cut it out.
I cannot believe to this day that that is your mother. I mean, here you are, the greatest stage actress of a generation. You're spawned by a troll.
George, just stop it.
I bet you were switched at birth. Somewhere out there is Ethel's real daughter, traveling with Ringling Brothers as the Wolf Woman of Barneo.
Thank you, Mother.
Thank you, Mother.
George, my hearing aid is in. Now grow up!
Neck. Am I getting old, Charlotte?
No, dear, you're just falling apart.
No wonder they didn't want me for that Pimpernel movie.
Us, dear, they didn't want us.
I'm gonna put us right back on top. George and Charlotte Hay in the new Frank Capra production, Twilight of the Scarlet Pimpernel.
There will be other movies.
We're so close. I can almost taste it. Yeah. Hollywood is such a cesspool nowadays. I mean, Frank Capra directs the Twilight of the Scarlet Pimpernel?
I didn't get a chance to meet him.
Nor did I. Nor do I care to, May Rottenhell.
I can see it now. Mr. Pimpernel goes to Washington.
Exactly. Ah.
Yeah, just chuck it. Did you read Variety, George?
No, Eileen had it.
Well, they said that they're starting filming this week, maybe. I forget when.
Oh, yeah. You know, Ronald Coleman's probably wearing my tights.
Oh, George, let them have their Ronald Coleman and their Greer Garson.
You're right.
That's what they want.
You're right.
I'm sure that Miss Garson will do a perfectly adequate job.
You're right.
Stupid. I met her once, did I tell you that? She was filming Pride and Prejudice, and I was next door filming a Apache Woman. She was cutting crusts off of little tea sandwiches, and I was boiling a pig in a teepee. She was making love to Laurence Olivier, and I was sacrificing a chicken with Chief Chuck-a-Chuck. Hey-ya, hey-ya, hey-ya.
Charlotte.
Oh.
How's
your neck?
It's better. Don't stop. Oh.
George. Can I ask you something?
Sure.
Did you sleep with Eileen?
Charlotte? How can you say such a thing?
I've seen the way you look at her.
She's a pretty girl. I'm not dead.
Not yet. I just want you to know that it's all right as long as you tell me.
You are off your rocker. Mm-hmm. It's extraordinary. It's unkind.
Well, George, as long as you tell me the truth, did you sleep with her or not? Yes or no?
No. All right? The answer is no.
Really?
It's killing you, isn't it, about the film?
It's got nothing to do with it, George.
It's slaying you that Miss Garson is swanning around the set in Hollywood while you suffer out here in Siberia.
That would be ridiculous.
I'm sure you had fantastical ideas of being slobbered over by a legion of toadies,
George.
Having your ears powdered.
All right, George, I'm sorry.
It's too late now. My feelings are hurt.
I saw that.
Saw what?
You big faker. Faker?
Fuck you, Thomas.
Faker? That's what you're talking about. Faker! Faker!
I'm warning you, Cheryl.
Eileen!
Don't look at me like that.
Fine, I will go and talk to her.
No. I'll go talk to her. You. Done enough damage for one day.
Oh, hello, Paul.
What's with Eileen? She walked right past me. I think she was crying.
She was born in Buffalo. Maybe she just realized she's still here.
Well, actually, she loves it here. She started out here in the theater, but what she really wants to do is television.
Oh, please.
She can do all right on TV. She's pretty. Wholesome.
Wholesome isn't the word. She could give milk.
Charlotte, have you talked to Roz lately?
Sunday. I brought up your name and she started screaming.
Oh, great.
You know, Paul, I always wondered why it was that you two broke up.
Oh, she wanted me to give up the theater so she can lead a normal life. Could you imagine anyone in your family being normal?
Hi, Mother.
Oh, Ken. Sweetie, when did you get here?
Oh, a few minutes ago.
Oh, we were just talking about you just this second.
Hi, Pop.
Hi, Roz.
How's your day going?
Oh, great. Never been
happy. Oh, good for you. I'm thrilled.
Thanks.
Okay, you're welcome.
It's going well.
How's your day in New York?
I came back to work for your parents.
Oh, nice.
I'll go check on Eileen.
Rosalind, why don't you just get married and get it over with?
Wish you would stop trying to ruin my life. It's my life, not your life.
All right. I'm sorry. You're right. I'm just the woman who gave birth to you. 12 pounds. 14 ounces. They needed a forklift.
Well, she's locked herself in her room. How's my little girl? Charlotte, how is it that two such plain people as ourselves could give birth to such beautiful offspring as this?
She isn't yours. I slept around.
Rosalind, have you come to your senses? You could walk right back into the company.
No, thank you. That's not why I'm here. I have a surprise for everybody. I seem to have lost it.
Paul, get in here. Look who's arrived.
God, don't you two ever stop. Look, I'll see you later. I gotta go.
Roz?
She's gone?
Yeah, she heard your name and she fled into the forest of Ardennes. Mm. You certainly have a way with women, Paul.
Thanks.
And how is little Miss Eileen?
She wouldn't open the door for me either. I wonder what happened.
She's in love with George. Yeah.
Charlotte, could you keep your menopausal hallucinations to yourself?
I'll go try again.
You do that. You are the company manager.
I'm also your second lead this week.
I beg your pardon?
Webster quit this morning. He packed his bags and left.
I'll sue the untalented little...
Why would he do that? Why would he just up and leave?
Because he hasn't been paid for 2 weeks.
Well, none of us have been paid for 2 weeks. What kind of feeble excuse is that?
No one told me that.
Well, Paul just did, didn't he? The big blabber mouth.
Sorry. By the way, have you talked to your agent this morning? He's called twice.
I have an agent? Surely you jest. Haven't you read about it in Scientific American? The minute my checks went down to four digits, he vanished from the face of the earth.
George, talk to me. Are we in trouble?
We'll be all right. We'll make it. It's television that's killing us. Entertainment by the yard. Putting us out of business.
George.
What's the matter with people? Don't they care anymore? Don't they know the difference? I'm not here. You haven't seen me.
George.
That's a native Buffalonian. Offer him some water and long grass. Maybe he'll go away.
Yes? Hi. What do you want?
I just want to tell you, before you say anything else, that I think you are the most wonderful actress that ever lived.
Please come. I'm Charlotte Hay.
Hi, I'm oh my God!
Knock, knock! Charlotte.
Hi.
How do you do? Richard Maynard, and you are...
I wasn't asking that. Apparently it's a trick question.
Are you famous too?
No, although some people say I remind them of Loretta Young.
Mr. Maynard is our lawyer, and he represents every major star in Hollywood.
Wow. Who's your favorite star? Besides Charlotte, of course.
Esther Williams. Do you know her?
I taught her to swim.
Wow!
I'm dearly sorry. Would you be able to come back another time?
Oh, sure.
Well, it's been absolutely stunning meeting you, whoever you are.
Wait, I remember Richard.
What are you doing here?
Well, I was sitting in my office this morning, making a great deal of money. And I realized I was rather bored. I thought about raising my billing rates. That usually does the trick. But then I thought, no. What I want is to take Charlotte to lunch.
So you just flew here from New York?
Well, I was in a plane.
Oh, Richard. I accept. I think I may need some cheering up myself.
All right, what's the brute done this time?
I don't know. Maybe nothing. Maybe I'm just tired.
Of course you are. It's inhuman the way he drags you from one city to another.
To top it off, I just found out we're not making our payroll.
Oh, well, I know about that.
You do?
Charlotte, it's serious. I've been telling George for months. He's got to start cutting down on expenses.
Well, is there anything I can do?
Well, could do a movie. Or better yet, television.
We could do a different play. Pygmalion always makes money.
Charlotte, yeah. Hello in there. It's 1953. The road is dead. The only stars left on tour are Cornell and the Muntz. And they have a combined age of 1,462.
What else am I supposed to do?
Well, for starters, he could marry me. I have a great deal of money and no one to spend it on. Oh, except a cat with a thyroid problem. He's gotten rather large. People came over for dinner last night. They thought I'd bought a new sofa.
Will you be serious?
I am being serious. I'm going to have to move out soon.
Richard.
Oh, Charlotte. Oh. I can't lie the way other men do and tell you that your cheeks remind me of Damask. I don't even know what Damask is. But what I do know is, Charlotte, you deserve better than this. Let me pamper you a little. We could go on a cruise. Anywhere you want in the world. Rochester. Schenectady.
Bishop, you do make me very happy.
Good. You deserve it. Quite frankly, so do I. I'm tired of living alone.
What about George?
I don't want to live with George. George. Oh, Charlotte. George. You're all I think about anymore. I'm so in love with you.
George.
Oh. Richard Maynard, lawyer to the stars, and you are...
Paul Singer, schlepper for two stars. Where's George?
I thought he was in his dressing room.
He's not there.
Something the matter?
No. But no, there's nothing the matter. I have a question, and it's for George.
Well, when you find him, tell him that I will be out for the morning, but you're just taking me to lunch.
Right. You two have a nice time.
Thank you. We intend.
Ethel, have you seen George?
What?
Where's George?
He's right behind me.
Stop. Give me those cereals. George.
No, I have to let them out. They're far too snug.
You, my look, pants.
Did you last? Your backside looks like a watermelon.
Nobody asked you.
George.
They need fixing.
Your ears need fixing.
George!
Oh. No, look what you've done. No wonder this company is going down the toilet.
George, I have some bad news.
What, bad news in this company? The House of Usher Repertory Theater?
I think you better sit down.
Sit down because I'll tremble. My knees will wobble uncontrollably. That's a stage convention, you idiot.
Eileen is pregnant! She says the two of you slept together in Detroit, and now she's pregnant.
That's a lie.
You didn't sleep with her?
With Cincinnati.
I think that's irrelevant.
Holy mother of God, Charlotte's gonna kill me.
I know!
She'll make my life a living hell, more so than usual. What can I do?
What?
Think of something, you idiot. That's what you're paid for.
All right, let me think. Okay, so Eileen could have the baby in the country, and you know, like, well, for relative, like an aunt or something, and we never tell Charlotte, ever. And then, when the baby is, like, I don't know, like, on the way, you can take trips every few months and, you know, have picnics and whatnot. And then, when the baby is actually born, and it's, like, 10 years old or something, you can cast her as a page and much ado about nothing, and you can put on shows together!
I need help, not Mickey Rooney.
I'm sorry. Look, you better just talk to Eileen about this.
Eileen, that poor kid. I better go see on her.
We better hurry. She has a doctor's appointment at noon.
Already?
They have to do a test or something.
What test?
I don't know.
A pregnancy test?
I have no idea.
So she might not actually be pregnant.
She says she's positive.
But she only thinks she's pregnant.
She's positive, but, well, she thinks. I mean, I don't really know how it
works. Where's the money? Is she pregnant or isn't she?
I don't know, George! I didn't examine her!
It's chilly out there. I need to get a wrap. Then I'll be back about 1:00.
Oh, good. Great.
Oh, and by the way, Richard is here and he's taking me to lunch.
Oh, bon appetit.
What if Eileen talks to her?
Oh, I doubt that.
Go in there and keep them separated. I got time to think.
George, she's gonna find out sooner or later.
Would you do what I'm telling you? Damn.
Piss.
Balls. Hi, George.
Eileen.
I guess Paul already told you.
Yes, Eileen. What can I say? What can I do?
Well, George, I think you already did it.
I'm sorry, Eileen. We were both out of control.
I was such a fool.
We were both fools.
And now we're having a little fool.
I hope he looks just like you.
Oh my God.
I can't do the matinee today.
But we don't have an understudy for him.
Well, I'll still be at the doctor's anyways.
The doctor's? Yeah. For a test to confirm
that's,
that you
that's
are.
That's right.
So you might not actually be...
George, I'm pregnant. I'm 2 weeks late and I've been tossing my guts up every morning for 3 days. What do you think it is?
Bad oysters?
I'll see you later.
Eileen, you haven't talked to Charlotte, have you?
I haven't seen her.
Oh, good.
So I left her a note.
What?
Well, she has to know sometime, and she's gonna figure it out when I start waddling around here like a duck. Romeo, Romeo, quack, quack, quack. Anyways, I scribbled it down on something. I think it was her copy of Variety.
Variety?
I've got to go now, George.
George, I can't find Eileen anywhere!
Oh. go to Charlotte's room and bring me her copy of Variety. George, there's a copy of Variety right there.
I don't want to read it, you idiot.
Then what would you...
Hello, George.
Hello, Paul.
Hi.
Paul, could you leave us alone for a few minutes?
Sure.
Stay right here.
Leave the room, Paul.
Yes, ma'am.
George, the strangest item has appeared in this week's Variety.
Charlotte, I
think you should read it, George, out loud. You see, because I may be having one of my menopausal hallucinations.
Charlotte.
Read it, George. Right there.
Box office biggie, Boffo and Burbs.
Below that.
Dear Charlotte, I'm carrying your husband's pile.
Child! I'm carrying your husband's child!
Right. I thought you should know, Eileen.
Well?
Charlotte, I am profoundly sorry. I made a grievous mistake. Can you ever forgive me?
No, George. I cannot forgive you. You betray me! After 35 years!
How?
Sorry, I left something in the dressing room. I'm sorry, Charlotte, but you shouldn't blame George. I guess I shouldn't have believed him when he said next season I could play Roxanne.
Roxanne? Roxanne?
You have to understand, Charlotte was right after a performance, and I was all full of that passion for Cyrano. I lost my head.
You lied to me.
I didn't want to, but you cornered
me. Put your hands on me.
Ow. What do you expect? I'm only flesh and blood. You expect me to be celibate all my life?
3 days! You could be celibate for 3 days!
Charlotte, please, stop. All right, stop.
I'm leaving with Richard on the next plane.
We have a matinee.
At the pack.
Charlotte.
Well, how'd it go?
Not good. George? George, say something.
I'm a hack. I was always a hack. Now I'm an even bigger hack. I have sunk to new depths of hackdom.
George, you can't give up. What about all your fans?
My fans? Okay. You call one, I'll call the other.
George, you made a mistake. Everybody makes mistakes. Let me talk to her, she'll listen to me.
It's too late, Horatio. Just cancel this afternoon's performance. In fact, cancel the entire tour.
You can't do that, you'll get sued.
Let the bastard sue me. Let him nail me to a cross. God knows I've suffered enough.
Hello? It's your agent from New York.
I'm not here.
He's right here. Would you just talk to the man?
Hello, Henry. How's the blood-sucking business? It must be important. It's noon and you're up for the day. All right, yeah, I'm listening. Well, yeah, I know they started filming. I have a little Ronald Coleman doll I've been sticking pins into. What? You're joking. Henry, if this is a joke, I'll kill you. What happened? Oh, that's wonderful. Henry, I love you.
George, what happened? Would you shut up?
Today? Yeah, I'll be here. All right, I'll call you.
Well?
We're back in business, my boy. Charlotte, get in here.
What do you say?
You're looking at a star, my boy. Gaze your fill, and don't mind the radiance. Squint if necessary.
What happened?
Yesterday, on the set of The Twilight and the Scarlet Pimpernel, Ronald Coleman made his first entrance and fell down a flight of stairs and broke his legs.
Oh my God.
As a consequence, the director of the film, Frank Capra, winner of 2000 Academy Awards, Mr. Hollywood himself, is flying here to see the matinee.
Frank Capra.
Yes. Goodbye, George.
Yes, yes, Charlotte. I'm sorry. Please, the most wonderful thing in the world has happened.
George.
Ronald Coleman is crippled.
What?
Henry just called. It seems that Mr. Coleman made a most dramatic entrance on the set of The Scarlet Pimpernel yesterday, and by creating headfirst on a flight of stairs.
What?
Broke his legs. Fractures, apparently, in both. Not one, both.
Henry told you this.
Yes. The studio is desperate. Every minute they delay is costing them a fortune. So, what director do you think is on his way right now to Buffalo, New York? I'll give you a hint. Give me a C.
C!
Give me an A.
A!
Give me a P.
P!
George.
I know. You're wondering, where do you fit into all of this? Well, if I do get the role, and it's beginning to look extremely likely, I will insist that you play Marguerite.
George, I don't know what to say.
I know.
Except that this is easily the most ridiculous lie you've ever told me.
Wait,
George.
Wait, you don't believe me? But we must believe.
George,
have I ever lied to you before?
Take care of yourself, George. Bye.
Charlotte, wait.
I said, bye.
George. I'm gonna kill myself. No, that's too easy. I'm gonna get very, very drunk. Then I'm gonna kill myself.
And then, now wait a minute. We can still do the matinee.
Who's gonna play Roxanne? Ethel?
Oh, there you are. I'm glad to say they're finished. No thanks to you. We'll go ahead and try them on. All right, I'll turn around.
As if you're modest.
That'll be the day.
George, give me the pants.
No.
George, will you give me the chair? It'll be worth it. Now stop it. Let me go.
Oh,
God damn it to hell.
Daddy, what's wrong?
Russ,
Paul.
Ah!
Daddy, where are you going?
George.
He's finally gone completely insane.
Yes. Could you wait one moment, please? George, that's Capra's New York office! What do I tell them? George!
Ugh. Paul, what's going on?
That is a very good question. Hi, he's in a meeting right now. Can Mr. Capra come tomorrow?
Frank Capra?
He's already on his way to the airport. Right. Oh my God!
Paul, what happened?
Come on, we gotta stop him! George!
Daddy?
George!
Daddy?
George! George!
Charlotte,
George!
What are you doing?
George!
You buy a newspaper and you go berserk.
Read that. George!
Disaster at
George.
MGM Studios. Carson on crutches. Carson walks.
She walked out? Mother, where's George?
I hope he's having a root canal.
Come on!
Do I have to?
George, come on!
George! George!
Grandma! Grandma! Have you seen Daddy? Too many times. No one's looking for him, too.
Mother?
Charlotte's back? Oh, that's great. This is great. Ethel, where does she go?
Through there.
Come on.
This is why I left the theater.
Would you come on?
Richard!
Your friend is very tiresome.
Richard!
marvelous Roz. Oh, Eileen, have you seen George?
No, but I never want to see you again in my life.
Oh, hell! Roz! George! Charlotte!
Paul?
Through there.
Roz, I've been looking all over for you.
Howard.
I'm ready. I can meet your parents.
I'm not there. You can meet them later. Daddy? Mother? Paul?
Ethel.
What?
When you see Roz, give her this note.
I am not your personal slave.
You give it to her, I will have you killed.
Oh, all right.
Where's the mafia when you need them?
I don't know, they must be in a hurry. They must run it around.
Usually is.
Yeah.
Daddy!
George! Ross! Did you find him?
No.
Oh, Rosalind, this is for you. It's from Mr. Potato Head.
Dear Roz, don't worry about me. I'll be back in a few days.
A few days?
Holy God.
Man, I can't find his father. Oh, maybe he's in the hotel.
Oh, Charlotte.
Oh, he's telling the truth. Frank Pepper really is coming to the main name today. You want this, please?
No
more, patsy woman.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Oh, fucking scared.
Charlotte.
Don't worry about me. I'll be back in a few days. Love, Daddy. Fine.